Oh, it looks like a little pickout. They may have gotten caught cannon. Here's the throw over the second, a little high, but a big beat out right there by Tomani to pick off Concan for out number one, Mercedes. And here's the pitch. Check swing. He did not go around, but it hits the zone, and it's strike three. Two gun. There's the 1-0. That one's hit out deep center field, and that ball is gonna go! Patrick Roach launches his second home run of the season, and the Muskrats take a 1-0 lead.
Real beautiful swing by Patrick Roach. You know, just goes the other way with a heater on the outer portion of the plate. That fastball catches a lot of plate. And coming in at 90, you don't got to do too much to hit it out of this yard. In fact, he crushed that ball 98 miles an hour off the bat, 382 into right field. It's a good, good shot off the bat of Roach. He had a lot of pop to that. And now Winnipesaukee draws first blood.
Pigs of the Appalachian League. And the 1-2. That one's lined over the right field, and that's going to stay fair. That will bring home Flores. Battaglia heading over to third. He's going to round it. No, he's going to stay put. Oh, he is going to go. A little drop from Covino at second, and it will be two runs on the double for Brady Day. It's 3-0 Winnipesaukee. Six hits in his last seven games, and he swings and misses on that, and that's strike three. First strikeout for Zach Davidson, and he gets himself out of trouble.
Been real good hitters so far, at least through the past week.
We'll see if Brown in the seventh spot can try and work things on. And he's got ones out over the center field. And just like that, this game is tied. Jaden Brown, what an unbelievable play. Nobody saw that coming.
Jaden Brown goes the other way. I just mentioned how the SwampBats are in need of Jaden to do something big. His first home run of the season. He just laces it the other way, and it really feels like Keene is finally starting to adapt to this ballpark. That's what you gotta do. Don't gotta crush it.
Oh, power. 3-2. And that's strike three. A little bit of a late second, but the umpire calls out DiMatteo. One gun. And located right between Dallas and Fort Worth. The 2-0. He hits that into center field. Going back, looking at the wall, and he jumps. He can't make it. It's out of here. It's another home run for the Muskrats, and Brendan Concannon puts them back on top.
Concannon just gets enough of it, and man, TJ McKenzie almost just made one of the best catches you'd ever see at this field. So close to robbing it, and McKenzie is upset with himself. He thought he should have had it indeed. I mean, that was as close as it gets for a robbery. And, you know, that's the Keene special, 323 feet of center field.
Conference did not qualify for their own conference tournament, but Kincaid will be looking to try and help them get back on the right path. 1-2. And he checked swing, and he got him looking. And that's strike three. Another strikeout looking for Mercedes, retires the side, but Brendan Concannon puts the Muskrats back on top with a home run. It's 4-3 Winnipesaukee after two.
294 last week. Here's the pitch to him. Inside, it gets away from DiMaggio, and this game is tied. Dan Covino comes around and scores. That is his 20th run scored of the summer, and it's 4-4, and the count's 3-0 to Tony Santa Maria. Product going into the senior year, 6-6-2-10. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Brown laces one to center. Back is Mercedes. Brown, do it again. Second three-run shot in back-to-back innings. Jaden Brown without a homer in nearly a month. He's got two in two innings, and it's 7-4 Keene. Blue down the sleeves. Here's the 1-2. In there, strike three called. Six strikeout for Davidson. He keeps adding on to his season high. That's the first out in the bottom of the fourth. Without a home run yet this summer. The catcher from FAU digs in against Justin Baines. Here's the 3-1. He swings and hits one high and deep to right field. Forget about it. Now he's got the homer. He slugs one up high and over the trees into the parking lot. 91 off the barrel. He adds on to the Keene's lead. It's 8-4 here in the fifth. Right on cue. Mention that he's without a homer. Now he's got one. And he's got three RBIs. It's 8-4. And it'll bring up Garrett Rice. Davidson comes set towards the chest. The 3-2 pitch. Flown in the air into right center field and deep. McKenzie, the center fielder, lining it up. He'll make the grab. Oh, Almonte makes the grab. Comes and chucks it in, but running in safely is Kincannon. It's a sacrifice fly. And obviously some miscommunication out there by Almonte and McKenzie, but they tap gloves and realize that they need better communication out there. It's the fifth Winnipesaukee run. It's 8-5. Frickin' leave in line for the win. 3-2 pitch. Flown in the air to deep right center. Back is McKenzie. To the wall he leaps. He brought it back! TJ McKenzie robs a homer and ends the fifth. Are you kidding? He just missed one earlier. He didn't miss this one. 8-5 Keene headed to the sixth at Alumni Field on Pure Aldi's 104.1 FM and the NECBL Broadcasting Network.
Went out to get that baseball instead of letting it travel.
Here's the 1-0. That one's grounded softly over the third. Grodell's frozen at third. The throw over the first is in time, and now one out left to go for the SwampBats. It could not have been any better for them as Santa Maria finds the ball quickly. 2-0. That one hit out into left field. Brown looking at that one. Between him and he'll make the catch, and that will end the ball game. Very close for Winnipesaukee, but they can't hold on as Keene, with their offense and their 8 runs, takes game 1 of the doubleheader against Winnipesaukee 8-5. Both teams with 4 hits and 2 errors. The win goes to Zach Davidson, the loss goes to Jeff Masso, and the save goes to Nick Hohenstein.
Yeah, complete team win for the SwampBats. They pick up Zach Davidson in great style. The offense explodes. Jaden Brown, 2 3-run jacks. We're going to get up here in the booth once we swing things to break. A 35-minute break before game 2 is underway.